The Reserve Bank Board expects its next interest rate move will be a hike, although it may not happen for another year. The cash rate has stood at a record low of 1.5% for a record 18th straight months. So what impact will it have on homeowners and their debt stress? Let's bring in our finance expert, David Sharpe from Globe Financial Planning. Hi, Sharpe.
Hi, Tivo. How are you?
I'm not too bad, thanks. How significant does a rate rise need to be to cause mortgage stress?
It doesn't need to be significant at all. That's really a bit of a worry at the moment. I want to talk about what the starting position at the moment is, which is nearly a million households in mortgage stress right now. That means roughly about a third or more of their income is going just putting a roof over their head. Now, if we had an increase of, say, just 0.5%, so two rate rises, and you had a $500,000 loan, that's an additional $2,500 per year that an already stressed household has to find. Now, at some point over the next year, we're already expecting over 50,000 defaults or arrears. That's just going to get worse if we have a rate rise.
That's concerning. OK, what should homeowners be doing to control their debt?
Well, first things first, pay down your expensive debt first. And the best rule of thumb there is whatever's got the highest interest rate, pay that down first. So if you've got credit cards at 18%, that's first. If you've got cars or personal loans at 9-8%, that's next, and then your mortgage last. If you can, pay principal and interest and not interest only. It has the benefit of getting your debt down, but also you're going to get a much, much cheaper interest rate as well. And the last thing I was going to say is don't be lethargic with your loans. People just let it be. Log in and actually work out what you're paying.
Yeah, do some research, do the further research. Should people consider fixing their mortgages?
Look, it's a great question. It's one I get asked all the time by clients, and often what they're trying to work out, are rates going to go up or down, right?
Yeah.
So I like to reframe it for a lot of clients, which is use it as a risk mitigation strategy. And what I mean by that's a fancy word, but what I mean by that is if rates go up, can you still afford your house and your mortgage? If you can't, maybe that's a really good indication that you might want to fix. Now, if rates go down and you've lost out, well, it doesn't matter. At least you're still in your house. So the downside, of course, of fixing is there is a limitation as to how much you can pay your debt off. So maybe consider a combination, a bit fixed and also maybe a bit variable.
Okay. All right. Finally, Sharpe, what are your money tips for this week?
Okay. First ones first is stress test your mortgage. Work out whether you can afford it, whether it's 2% higher or not. Build yourself a buffer. Maybe see if you can get through 3 months worth of without making repayments. So you've over saved. And lastly, this is the most important one, Tracy, demand, and I say this, demand a discount from your bank. There are rates out there under 4% for home loans. Make sure you're getting under 4%. If you're not, you're paying too much. If the bank doesn't give you a discount, move.
All right. I'll go and demand then.
Demand it.
That's my next step. Right, Sharpe, thanks so much. We'll chat to you again soon.
Thanks, Tracy.